Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can perform linear search in Java. So first I am creating a class whose name is linear search. Inside this class, I am going to define definition of main function. In this main function, I am going to implement the code which will perform linear search in 1D array. First, I am declaring instance of scanner class. For this scanner class, I am going to import a package. Name is util and its class scanner. Scanner is predefined class, that's why we have to import this util package, and through util package you can import scanner class and you can use it in your program. Now I am declaring an array, a variable n, variable f and I. Now I am going to display a message. Enter size of array. Entered size will be stored inside n variable. So now I am going to allocate memory for this array. So this way I have dynamically created array in Java. Now I am going to receive values for this array from user. So again, system.out.println, and the message will be enter elements. So user has to enter n number of elements. For reading n numbers, I am rotating a loop. This loop will repeat n times, and the entered number will be stored inside array using this input.nextint method. This way I have received all the elements for array. Now again I am implementing system.out.println, which will display enter the number you want to search. So we have to search a particular number, whether it is available in array or not, that is linear search. So I have to receive that number. To store that number, I am again declaring a variable num. So statement is num equals to input dot nextint. So this way I have received three different type of values from user. First one is size of array, second one all elements of array, and third one is the number which user want to search whether it is available in array or not. Now I can apply a loop. It will repeat n times, and this loop will check whether num is available in arr array or not. So condition is arr of I double equals to num. So I am going to compare num with arr I. If this condition is true, it means number is available inside array. So you can see I have declared a variable f at line number 8, which is initialized with 0. So f belongs to found or not found. So if this condition is true, then I can assign 1 into f, and I am going to break this loop. Because if number is found, then there is no need to repeat the loop, because if number is found at a particular position, it means number is available in the array. And value of f will become 1. So after completion of this loop, we have to check value of f, whether it is 1 or 0. So if f is 1, it means number is present. So system.out.println, we can print a particular message, number is present, or this message can be anything. else number is not present. So this way, through this if condition, I have checked the value of f variable. Accordingly, the result will be displayed on output screen. So this way I have implemented the linear search method in Java. Now I am going to execute this code so that you can understand how it will work. So I am going to drive inside Java folder. I have saved this program with linearsearch.java. You can see it here at the top of Notepad file. So first I have to compile this code. You can see it is compiled successfully because it is not showing any kind of error. Now I can easily execute this code. I am searching that file. I am again executing this code. So you can see now it is executing properly. I forgot to save the code. I have entered size as 5. Now I am going to enter 5 elements. Now it is asking enter the number you want to search. So I am entering 6. You can see the output. It is showing number is present. Again, I am executing this code. This time I am entering size as 4. Numbers are 2, 3, 4, 5. And I am going to search 8. You can see it is showing number is not present. So this way you can see the program is working properly in both the conditions, whether number is available or not available. So I hope you have understood how we can perform linear search in Java. Thank you for watching this video.